Hey guys, today I'm going to tell you,
today I'm going to show you guys how to make your own screen protector. So first you're just going to need an iPod or iPhone case. Then it's going to have to match. Mine doesn't match the whole foam because my phone is really small. Make sure it's going to be able to fit the screen. And you want to cut it just to the exact size. So yeah, this is what it looks like. It's basically clear. It's made out of this material. That's old, so I'm just going to have to look for my phone real quick. I misplaced it here. I can't find it for some reason. It's gonna have to look harder because apparently can't find it. I know where the case is, but the phone. Domestic. Let me just look. I'll be right back. why it took me so long. Sorry. Sorry, it literally took me so long. I couldn't find it. Maybe it's just under my bed. Sorry about that. So it just fits perfectly on my phone, and I'm trying to find out a way that I can tape it on. Sorry, that sounded so stupid, but okay. Just gonna line it up right here. Still gonna be able to take pictures with it, of course, but. Because, duh, I cut out a hole so I can take pictures. I cut out a hole. Then when it goes into the phone case, just as kind of hidden. This phone case is really good to do a lot. And you can still literally, like, you can still touch through it, like that. You can take it off at whatever time you want. See, you can basically still take pictures because you see the holes cut out there. Basically homemade, you can make better version. Do not like this phone case, so I might get a new one at the Apple Store. So yeah. Comment down below if you dudes have any questions. But yeah. Literally. Monday, February 18th. It's 2:21 in the afternoon. So yeah, basically what it is. So sorry it took me so long. It was in here the whole dang time. So could have known that. I actually should have known that. So. Just